Hello and good morning. Today is Monday, March 13, 2023, and we are continuing with our Daily Bible reading. We've reached so far Exodus chapter 8. We're only going to read verses 20 through 30, which you can see right here, 22 through 30. And if you want to grab a print, you know, a physical Bible, go ahead and grab it, and we'll get to reading. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Is titled The Plague of Flies, because remember we're still reading about the plagues that God is putting, and they call it the marvels, the wonders that God is doing in Egypt excuse me, so that to show the Egyptians and the Israelites that God is with them while he is delivering them from Egypt, from slavery. And these things, they're gonna tell their future generations about, like, yes, this actually happened in our country. This is how God took us out. These are the signs that he did. And it was like, it was crazy because we've never seen such a thing. So it says, verse 20. Then the Lord said to Moses, get up early in the morning and confront Pharaoh as he goes to the river and say to him, this is what the Lord says. Let my people go so that they may worship me. If you do not let my people go, I will send swarms of flies on you and your officials, on your people, and into your houses. The houses of the Egyptians will be full of flies. Even the ground will be covered with them. But on that day, I will deal differently with the land of Goshen, where my people live. No swarms of flies will be there, so that you will know that I, the Lord, am in this land. I will make a distinction between my people and your people. This sign will occur tomorrow. And the Lord did this. Dense swarms of flies poured into Pharaoh's palace and into the house of his officials. Throughout Egypt, the land was ruined by the flies. Then Pharaoh summoned Moses and Aaron and said, go sacrifice to your God here in the land. But Moses said, that would not be right. The sacrifices we offer the Lord our God would be detestable to the Egyptians. And if we offer sacrifices that are detestable in their eyes, will they not stone us? We must take a three-day journey into the wilderness to offer sacrifices to the Lord our God as he commands us. Pharaoh said, I will let you go to offer sacrifices to the Lord your God in the wilderness, but you must not go very far. Now pray for me. Moses answered, as soon as I leave you, I will pray to the Lord, and tomorrow the flies will leave Pharaoh and his officials and his people. Only let Pharaoh be sure that he does not act deceitfully again by not letting the people go to offer sacrifices to the Lord. Then Moses left Pharaoh and prayed to the Lord, and the Lord did what Moses asked. The flies left Pharaoh and his officials and his people. Not a fly remained. But this time also, Pharaoh hardened his heart and would not let the people go. Amen. The part that I do want to point out is verse 23, how it says, God says, I will make a distinction between my people and your people. This sign will occur tomorrow. So there's things that God is going to allow between groups of people that live in the same area, work in the same job, they go to the same church, they participate in the same things that are moral, they have values, you know. And the thing is that when God wants to do something with his people, there is a distinction between his people. His people are not a certain race. No. His people are, we can say it's like a culture. I mean, it is a culture. And you can be from any country, from any city, from any street, from anything. And you are considered God's people if your heart is right with the Lord. If you truly are seeking God the way that you should. And how is that so? You read the Bible, you'll find out. Go to a church that preaches the truth. And how do you know that they're preaching the truth? You got to read the Bible, of course. You pray for the Holy Spirit to guide you. The Bible does talk about the Holy Spirit that teaches you what is right, what is true, and how God put teachers and prophets and pastors and all these things, leaders. And so, you know, you will have the direction that you need. Just give it a chance and give it a shot. But I just wanted to point that out, because remember we're saying that when you're reading, try to pick out a section that calls your attention, something that stands out to you that you can think about throughout the day, or you can try to think more about, to meditate on. And yeah, that's the verse I pick. So that's everything for today. May God bless you. May you have peace today. And tomorrow we're going to be in the book of Exodus chapter 9. If you want to read independently, go right ahead. The program that we're using is on the page. If you want to read on your own, but we'll be here tomorrow.